Children, this is Anusha, your science teacher. Here you to teach you a topic in rain, where does it comes from? In that subtopic is evaporation, formation of clouds. How the evaporation takes place. You know, in your from your childhood you are learning about this evaporation and how it is formed. So the wet clouds which are kept out for the sunlight, where does that water goes? You know, where does it goes? It is going to fall down. If sunlight is not there, the wet clothes are not going to get dry. Yes, if sunlight is not there also, the wet clothes are going to get dry. In rainy season, very less sunlight you will see. But still the water, wet clothes are going to. Where does that water goes? How the water is, where does that water goes? It's a big question to us, isn't it? So, let me read the lesson. So that in these questions are there, you are supposed to answer. What happens to the water in the wet clothes when they are kept in the sunlight? So what happened to the water in the wet clothes? What happened to the water in the wet clothes? They are going to get dried up. The water in the wet clothes are going to get dried up when you kept in the sunlight. So when we want to dry clothes quickly, we wave them about or keep them under the fan. We'll keep under the fan, isn't it? Here is another question to you. Does the water in the wet clothes dry up only due to the sunlight or due to the other reasons? Not only due to the sunlight, due to the wind, it is going to get dried up. Yes. Next, you must have seen that water on the wet roads, roofs are going to get dried up. How they are going to get dried up? You know what is the reason? How? Only the sunlight? Yes. You know, when you heat the water, so what happens? It is going to form in the form of a water vapor. It's going to get escape in the form of a water. When you heat it, it is going to get escape in the form of a water vapor. Water vapor. So, like that only, even the wet clothes also. Water in the wet clothes are going to get vaporized. Isn't it? In the form of a water vapor. Next, if you heat water kept in the bowl by using a stove, you may notice that water vapor coming from the bowl, vapors coming from the bowl. Thus, when the water is heated, it gets converted into vapor and mixes with the air. This is what happens to the water in the wet clothes also. So what happens if you put you take 15 ml of water and you keep on heating it. When you heat it, you, after some time, you can't see the water in the bowl. What happens to that water? That water, because of the heat supplied by you, the water is going to change its shape into water vapor, which is going to get evaporized, which is going to get vaporized. So you can't see any more water. The same thing happens in the wet clothes also. In wet clothes, you are keeping any heat? No. Due to the sunlight present in the wet clothes, present in the atmosphere, it is going to raise the temperature and take out the air from the water from the clouds. Next. Water from the clothes. Next, the process of water changing into water vapor. So what is evaporation now? You know, the water is going to get vaporized when you heat it. So what is evaporation? The process of water changing into water vapor means the process of water changing into water vapor is evaporation. ఎక్కడ ఆఫ్ చేసాను వేపర్ ఈజ్ ఎవాపరేషన్ సో వాట్ వాటర్ చేంజింగ్ ఇన్ టు వాటర్ వేపర్ ఈజ్ ఎవాపరేషన్ సో వాట్ హ్యాపన్స్ ఇన్ అవర్ నేచర్ ద వాటర్ ఈజ్ ఇన్ బిగ్ బిగ్ లేక్స్ బిగ్ బిగ్ సీస్ బిగ్ బిగ్ రివర్స్ ఓషన్స్ దే ఆర్ గోయింగ్ టు గెట్ వాట్ హ్యాపన్స్ ఇఫ్ హీట్ ఈజ్ మోర్ ఇన్ సమ్మర్ సో వాట్ హ్యాపన్స్ డ్యూ టు ద హీట్ దిస్ వాటర్ ఈజ్ గోయింగ్ టు గెట్ హీటెడ్ అప్ ది వాటర్ వెన్ వాటర్ ఈజ్ గోయింగ్ టు గెట్ హీటెడ్ అప్ వాటర్ వేపర్స్ ఆర్ ఫార్మ్డ్ సో దీస్ వాటర్ వేపర్స్ వేర్ డస్ దే గో దీస్ వాటర్ వేపర్స్ ఆర్ నథింగ్ బట్ వాటర్ అగైన్ ఇఫ్ దే గో అప్ ఇన్ టు ద ఎయిర్ వెన్ దే గో అప్ ఇన్ టు ద ఎయిర్ they'll go up into the air so what happens this water is going to convert into water vapor that is your evaporation so then what happens slowly due to the if the more sunlight and more heat is there this water is going to convert into water vapor so this water vapor formed due to the evaporation becomes a part of air this water vapor what where it does not go into another world and stay back it will be in the form it will be mixed with the air in the atmosphere and can't usually be seen you can't see this water vapor you can feel the water vapor hot water vapor in like some coastal areas you can feel the water vapor but you can't see the water vapor where does it goes it is a continuous process due to the sunlight the water gets heated up the water vapor in the form of air it goes so the water vapor which enters into the air through in the form of a water vapor will form what clouds in the sky this water the water will be there in the oceans and rivers due to the sunlight it is going to get evaporated as you know water if you heat up the water vapor is formed like that only it is formed when it is formed like that what happens to these water vapors all they are going to form like a clouds they are formed like a clouds in the sky they are going to form like a clouds in the sky so what happens water vapor when they get heated up they are going to form clouds in the sky where does this water vapor go they mixed with the air and they form clouds in the sky thank you